is correct. The reason for that is because I did it wrong. It's not I did it wrong. I didn't make everything to be true all at once. It's not, it's like a little bit contradicting each other. Okay?
So in the take-home exam, I found that there is multiple answer because what I made doesn't make everything come all together. Okay, but whatever you do, the answer come pretty close. So it will be okay. Any question for take-home exam? It's due tonight, right? And if you submit it late, I just give you zero. Okay, whatever reason that you have, unless there's a some like earthquake or something. Have you finished? Victor, you done?
Yeah, the problem that I was having with the pressure drop with heat for gas, I solved it taking smaller steps. I don't know why.
What about Yash? You done?
Yeah.
Isaac, you done?
Yes, but the last part, the graph match with your...
The what?
So
pressure drop or what?
No.
Last two.
Transitions. Transition each J
for vertical two.
Okay.
It's amazing.
It's just a vertical line. It won't match. Okay. Because the one in the
software
is not transition J. What I taught you, just transition J for now. But what is in the software is not transition J, so it won't match. If it's match, this means you are a little bit ahead of the class. You can make it. When you see the book just shows the straight line, right? Then it should be okay. Any other question for the take-home exam? Did you submit? Sometimes there could be like technical problem. I think during summer 2016 or 15, there's a C++ course that I gave during the summertime, and one student tried to submit it, and he submitted it by, I think, 2 seconds or something. He got zero. Okay. So don't be late. Submit it right now. Submit it right now.
Yesterday.
You submitted yesterday?
Yesterday the platform was down.
What was today?
I'm not checking, but yes, I did. In the case of Blackboard is down, okay. How many megabytes of the file? More than 5 megabytes?
No.
Less than 5 megabytes. What about you, Victor? Less than 5 megabytes.
Oh,
you need to submit it in Blackboard. In the case that it's down, you can email it to me. But if it's not down, I check the Blackboard. Any email that have the size more than 1 megabyte, I typically delete it because my mailbox is full. I'm sorry. I try to delete it quick. I haven't posted the extra point. 10% extra point that we talk about on the slug flow. You remember? There's a curve, the full metal tether over there. I think you can do that. It's due, what did we agree upon? Like one day before grade submission day. Okay. So in case that you're about to get B, do that, you get A. If you just get A, do that, you get A plus or something. Okay. No more questions? Let's start. Last time,
we promised about the quiz.
We promised about the quiz, and the quiz was about transition, full transition. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. I don't think we have transition I. How is it? Okay, 11 or 4, we're still fine. So we talk about what's this equation? Vs L equal to 3.0 something something something. Transition E governing equation. We talk about this, right? Then we talk about existence of transition E. It's not the same thing as the rho squared GD squared over something to the power of 2.25 greater than or equal to 4.36. That is the existence of transition E. Okay? It's not transition B. Then we talk about transition F. You recall that? The final form of transition F. Okay. Then transition G. We derive transition H for the case of vertical flow, right? At the end, we get this equation, which is a little bit better than the book. It's more or less the same. That much. Okay. Transition H. And we talk about transient J, right? And we get equation for transient J. You recall that? And last time we go through bubble flow. So step one, for vertical flow, we determine the flow pattern. Once the flow pattern is known, then we calculate pressure drop. Okay. And let me remind you, this kind of calculation, the objective is to get pressure drop. It is using the well, riser of subsea pipeline. Okay. And as the well develops, we may have more water coming out, it forms emulsion, viscosity go up, the flow pattern may change. It may work the first day, or the first year, or first 5 years, but year 11, year 15, when it has water coming out, have a viscosity going up, it may not work. How do we know that? If the flow pattern should change or not? They ask you. Okay? They typically do the use a commercial software to run it. But how do you know that the software gives you the right answer? You don't know. It is in the future, right? It's a prediction of year 10, but now you are at year 5. Is the value or result from multi-million dollars or multi-million license fee that is very expensive, is going to be correct? Is it correct? You don't know. They don't know either. When it's expensive, it doesn't mean that it's correct. It could be just wrong. Okay? It's not about the simulator is wrong, it's about the... It could be simulator is wrong, but most of the time, no, it's not like that. Sometimes, your colleagues, or maybe yourself, put in a wrong value. Instead of 0.01, you put 0.1. Something like that. And there are several blocks to put anything in. Fluid composition, test of viscosity, many, many things. How do you know that it's correct? You do this simple calculation. Use order of magnitude of viscosity, order of magnitude of fluid property, and try to find out, does it match? If your calculation far away from the simulator, we have to double check both. You may double check until you find something. Most likely is simple calculation has less tendency to have error, but the simulator where there are several details to put something in could have typo. Okay. It can be just one typo, one small typo, but it made the prediction wrong. Okay? So this is useful. Okay, step one, find the flow pattern. Step two, calculate the pressure drop. We talk about bubble flow. In bubble flow, number one, we calculate actual alpha. And after we know alpha, we calculate everything like single phase case, use weighted average of the property based on that alpha or actual hold-up. So we talked about that already. You recall that? Okay. So one thing that I may skip a little bit is about this angle thing. Okay, this picture, I didn't really talk about it. Let's go over it a little bit. Okay, when we substitute it, we use Vg equal to Vsg over alpha. But when I put it over there, I have V0 sine theta equal to that expression. Okay, and I use V0 sine theta equal to Vg minus C0 Vm. Okay. I did that because V0 is upward. V0 sine theta, when theta is an inclination angle, is in the direction of the flow, same direction as Vg. If velocity is in the different direction, we cannot add or subtract them, right? In the scalar way. Just that. So that's why there is a sine theta. So this is the final equation to be solved for angle near 90 degrees. Okay. Solve it, get alpha, use weighted average based on that whole up, actual whole up, to get all three property and calculate it like pseudo single phase case. Good enough. Can you do it quick in your calculator? So this means you have to pre-program it. Something, right? And they already tell you how to pre-program it. No question on this part. Okay, we start at this slide last time. Any question before we go over this? C0
is
C0? Are you talking about this?
Yes.
Oh, okay. So distribution coefficient, okay, is between 1, 1.5. Most probable value is 1.2. This is vertical flow on your vertical flow. Horizontal flow, we use 1. Okay, but that is for Vg LS or SL. Gas velocity in the slug body for horizontal flow. But for translational velocity, we still use C0 equal to 1.2. It's not quite the same thing, okay? Alright. These three students, they are done with the take home exam already. How about you? Are you done?
Almost done.
Before you came, transient J that Isaac found was not matched to the simulator. It's just a straight line, but simulator give curve. And I told him that is okay. Does it help? Does it help you a little bit?
Okay.
Okay. I hope you finish and submit it on time. Any late submission, just get zero. If the blackboard down, email me. Okay, vertical slug flow. We have Tatio Bani unified model that you used early on. It's from 0 to 90 degrees. Okay. What does it mean? This means you can do it already. Right? Use your model. But that's not thin profile, it could be a little bit difficult. But if you decide to use that model for vertical flow, VTB has to be VTB for closure relationship for vertical flow. Okay. Drift velocity has to be the case for vertical flow. Alright? Like slug frequency, slug length, that has to be for vertical flow. And then you can do tether by knee. And you may probably start at the middle because the shape is like uniform. So I'm saying, and at the end maybe doesn't have any bubble. So in here, Shorthand presents a simplified model for vertical flow. Okay. Detailed vertical slab flow model can be found from Fernandez et al. In 1983. Sylvester has a simplified version of that. And we are going to talk about it more in detail because it's easier to get the pressure drop. Okay. HLRS comes from correlation of cross relationship. Length of Taylor bubble cap. Okay, this cap is much shorter than the length of the Taylor bubble, length of Taylor bubble cap. Just the cap part is a lot shorter than the whole thing. Okay. This is for this model. Alright? Film has a constant film thickness. This part, constant film thickness. Delta L, that's what this model is. So this means why do we want to use this model instead of tighter bending? Think about it a little bit. If you use tighter bending, okay, what happens is you get the profile in this region, but it's just chalked. It doesn't mean much, right? The whole thing may be okay 1 feet, you get 0.5 inch done. It's not the solution yet, and the rest is like constant film thickness, right? What are we going to do over there? So maybe another way is acceptable to Sylvester model. Okay. In this model, we start with overall mass balance. This overall mass balance is based on velocity. It's not a freezing method, right? It's based on velocity. If you don't have V over there, you need X. You remember that? Okay. Now look at VSG. VSG is beta VGTB multiplied by alpha plus 1 minus beta VGRS multiplied by 1 minus HRS. Where does this thing come from? It's vector. Where does this equation come from?
Mass balance.
It's just a mass balance. But in this case, the field is constant, right? So basically, this equation of VSG come from that, but it's based on like gas phase. So if you look at this, we divide both sides by like density or cross-section area or something. Ratio of length is the same as ratio of time. Okay? Lf over Lu is Tf over Tu. And over here we have Tu, over here we have Tf. If it is constant, it's just basically just weighted average. Okay? Whole up, if you divide it by that and that, so it's just whole up, multiplied by velocity, multiplied by time, plus whole up multiplied by velocity and time. We can do the same thing for the gas phase. So instead of VL, VL divided, WL is mass flow rate, right? Mass flow rate divided by rho L become volumetric flow rate. Volumetric flow rate divided by AP become VSL. We can do the same thing for the gas phase, right? So we will have weighted average. Basically, it's a weighted average based on time ratio or length ratio of velocity multiplied by whole up in that range. But this case, we talk about gas, so we use alpha or Y fraction. Okay, so we have velocity whole up time fraction, velocity whole up time fraction because we divide by TU. In this case, for the case of gas, we have velocity, VGTB is the Taylor bubble zone, whole up, or in this case, for the gas phase, is alpha, plus multiplied by time fraction or length fraction is the same thing. Plus velocity, volume fraction, and length fraction is a weighted average. And then we get VSG. So this equation can be said that it's from mass balance. Okay, got it? To derive this equation in full, we would write WG equal to 1 over TU parentheses VGTV rho GAP alpha LLS TS or something and so on. You got it? Same equation have similar form for the case of gas, analogous form. All right. So VSG is QG over AP, right? And this thing is just a time fraction. So is if you look at this equation, it's basically QG, total gas flow rate, over area is 1 over slug unit period multiplied by gas volume in tail bubble plus gas volume in slug body, right? So V alpha, that's kind of gas volume. So it's a weighted average. Alright. Nothing strange happened yet. But now we add minus sign over there for the case of VSL. That is because VLTB is going down. Okay? So I put absolute sign over there and put minus sign over there. Okay. Actually, we don't have to use a minus sign, but we have to consider the sign. I have to use vector. But okay, let's put the absolute value over there so it's not that confusing, but we know that it's falling down, so we put a minus sign. So this equation is a mass balance for liquid phase. Good. Which is directly come from this equation. Okay. It's the same. It's just divided by rho L and AP. Just that. So now, Sylvester model start with two equations. Mass balance for the gas phase, mass balance for the liquid phase. Question? No question yet? Okay. For vertical flow, VSL in tight turbine has this form. Okay. So this is just a mass balance, right? And this slide is basically how we derive it. Okay? Got it? So I show you that we can arrive with the same expression in Sylvester if we start from tighter by the integration form. We start with the integration form, but we say, hey, instead of this, we say this is constant, doesn't change which length. We take it out. We put bar over it. These two, multiplication of those two doesn't change with length, not individual term. We don't need to have that strict criteria. We just say multiplication of that is constant with length. We take it out, we put bar on top, and we define that as this. So basically we arrive at the same equation. What does it say? So this means in Sylvester model, velocity in the film is constant. In Sylvester model, it's not like a bullet shape, it's like that rectangle shape. Constant film thickness. Constant film thickness, of course, we have constant velocity. Constant film falling velocity. Okay? We arrive at the same thing because it's just a mass balance. Alright, the next part is equation of pickup rate. So pickup rate for the vertical flow, you remember equation for x? which page number that have definition of x, that will be multiplied by h l of s equal to that will be multiplied by h l t b, right? That's what it is. Pickup rate, but it's of course it's half rho, it's half a p. You understand that, right? We can have the pickup rate, same thing for the case of gas. So it's a relative velocity multiplied by alpha equal to the relative velocity multiplied by alpha for the teleportable zone and for the liquid slug zone. So this is VTB minus VGLS, and this is VTB minus VTTB. For the case of liquid, we have falling film. So this VTB is treated as scalar, positive value. To not get confused, but we put negative value, negative sign over there. So that VTB is falling down. So let's put it there. So we have pickup rate equation for case of liquid and gas. Right? So now we have how many equation? Four, right? Mass balance for gas, mass balance for liquid. Pickup rate for gas, pickup rate for liquid. Okay. Closure relationship for VTB. Okay, closure relationship is the same, but cosine beta term drop, cosine of pi over 2 is 0. So we have this. Okay. VGLS equation. What is this VGLS equation? Where does it come from? Which model have VGLS? Double Humboldt or Tete Humboldt? Yes. Double Humboldt consider that VGLS and VLLS are the same. Or Tete Humboldt consider VGLS separately. Got it? So it's not Double Humboldt. This comes from Tete Humboldt. It's a closure relationship. So we have closure relationship for VTB, right? And closure relationship for VGLS. C0 for VGLS, okay, not for VTB. It's one for horizontal flow. Okay? Now we have six equation. Alright? Mass balance for both. Pickup rate for both, VTB closure relationship, VGLS closure relationship. Alright, what are we going to do with this equation? I think we have 8 unknown. Is it? I wrote here, okay, we have 6 equation, we have 8 unknown. Those unknown are beta, time ratio or length ratio, VGTB, VGLS, HRTB, HRLS, VLTB, VLLS, and VTB. Those are unknown. Okay, assume that we know C0. Alright. So we have 8 equation, 6 equation, 8 unknown. Doesn't work. Right? Mathematically, you don't get unique solution. You need to find more equation. Two more equations are needed. And we have it for VRTB and VHLRS. So for turbulent flow, falling film, we have new closure relationship. This one. This is contribution directly from Sylvester model. Okay. VLTB equals square root something 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 G delta L. Which page number? Everyone tell me please. What is the value of G? 32.2 or 9.8? 9.8. What is the value of delta? Meter, inch, feet, or what is the unit for delta L? Millimeter? Or is something for you to read later? It's given in the book, right? Somewhere over there. You did kind of matter here, alright? Okay, so we have closure relationship is a relationship between film thickness and the velocity of the film. If film is thick, okay, it falls down fast. It feels thin, it falls down slow. Make sense to you? Okay. Then we have to do a little bit more math. Okay. Alpha is y minus HRTB, so this alpha, and alpha TB is pi, where is this thing? D minus 2 delta. Where's alpha TB? Y fraction in the Taylor bubble zone. And that is the area of circle shape that occupied by the Taylor bubble. We assume that it's circle. So the diameter is the pi diameter minus 2 delta L. Why do we need 2? Isaac, where does that number 2 come from? We have film on both sides. That is a pi. So this side has film, this side has film. So diameter for the gas core is just that. Alright, so this is a circular shape. That also circular shape. So this is the expression for VTB, FRTB. Do the math. Get the expression for delta. Substitute this value over there. Then we get the closure relationship between velocity and hold on. This is to change everything in the terms of this unknown. Look at this. This doesn't have delta as an unknown. We don't need delta. We don't want delta. We want to transform everything in the form of that unknown. So the objective is we have eight equations, eight unknown, and we use Gaussian elimination to solve it and get analytical solution. Or you can get numerical solution too. Alright, that is one more equation that we need. And we need another one. Closure relationship for HROS. Okay. Shoham textbook suggests this closure relationship from Gomez et al. 2000. What does it mean? This means it works just air water. Or maybe oil with low viscosity. If your oil viscosity has it happen to be like 25 centibar, and or if something strange happened, you have some kind of surface tension reduction, some kind of surfactant, maybe this equation doesn't hold. Okay, so keep in mind that this equation performs best when it is low viscosity oil. Alright, it's better than just random guess, man. A 0.6, a 0.7, so this equation is better than that. So now we have an equation at unknown. Then we can solve it. Make sense? Alright. What is the difference between Sylvester model and Taylor bubble model? Sylvester model, strictly for vertical flow. Taylor bubble is any angle. Okay? It doesn't mean that Taylor bubble is better. Actually, it's better, but okay. Sylvester model is simplified form. You can do it quicker by using the Sylvester model. You don't need to do, I think maybe a long time ago. Right now, it's just a matter of click. But you have to spend a lot of time to code it. You may realize it by now. Okay? But at that time, okay, you have to use a punch card, put it in the mainframe, do RK4 or something. No, this is faster. Alright? Very nice. It's like, okay, to 10 milliseconds, 0.5 seconds or something, it's quick. Alright, how do we solve it? Step 1, get HROS. This is from closure relationship, right? We get it right away, we can get it right up front. Get VGRS, sorry. That's come up front. Ben Dixon gave me VTB. You get it up front. Alright? Then, I rearrange equation. Okay. The green thing is kind of known. Purple thing is unknown. So So from the volume or mass balance for gas phase, I get this equation. Okay, beta equal to something, something, something. So equation one, I rearrange it. I get that. Equation 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Is this a linear? Is it linear equation? System of linear equation means constant multiplied by unknown 1 plus constant multiplied by unknown 2 plus constant multiplied by unknown 3. Never be unknown multiplied by unknown or unknown to the power of 0.2 or something or exponential function of unknown. Is this linear? No, it's not. Look, we have unknown multiplied by unknown multiplied by unknown. If I try to blindly solve it numerically, Isaac, what method do I use?
to solve
system of nonlinear equation.
Oh, you can use system of nonlinear.
Huh?
You just got a name
there. Did it teach you? Did you watch that video?
Just a non-linear equation.
Okay, if it's system of linear equation, you can use Gaussian elimination. If it is non-linear, you use Newton and his friend? Jacobi.
Oh, yeah.
You linearize it by calculating Jacobian matrix. Right? You have to linearize it. And then you use kind of Newton method to solve it. And within that, you have to do Gaussian elimination, like inverse symmetric, something.
Why
it's kind of Newton-Raphson. But it's Newton-Raphson for n dimension. Regular Newton-Raphson is just one dimension, right? But for n dimension, Newton-Raphson, the slope term becomes Jacobian matrix. Just that. Okay, this is like very, very fast forward, but I hope you understand, okay? Especially those who take numerical method already. If you haven't taken it yet, take it next year. I'll teach you how to do it. It's not that easy, it's not that difficult. In Python, you just type one line and everything, boom, done, okay? All right, we have an equation. I rearrange it a little bit. So, I have equation for beta. I calculate everything already, right? I calculate three of them. So instead of, I calculate three of them, instead of eight equation, eight unknown, I calculate three unknown already. So I have just five unknown, right? Because I solved three of them. I rearrange the one for beta because we have five equation, but we should have five unknown, okay? By doing that, put everything here. So VSG expression, that is mass balance for gas phase. Second one is the mass balance for liquid phase. Third one is pickup rate for liquid phase. Fourth one is pickup rate for gas phase. Fifth one is the field profile thing. I mean the new correlation, relationship between thickness and velocity. Okay, we have five equations. What are our unknown? Beta, something, 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 right? So this equation is basically the same as equation one, right? It's just equation one, I write it in another way. So the rest of this is just how I solve it. How I solve it doesn't need to be the same way of how Shoham solve it, or how you solve it, or how Sylvester solve it. But I guarantee you, doing it my way work. Alright? You can do some other way if you want to, but this work. It has many other ways to make this work too. So I list my five equations, I list my unknown, and I check, okay, equation one I have beta. X mean half, okay? And I have VGTB, half HRTB. Equation two, what unknown do I have? What unknown do I have? Equation three, equation four, equation five. If you look at this, it's not a dense matrix. It's not like I have every unknown in every equation. It's not that. So if I try to solve it, like use the Newton-Jacobian method, I have to be stupid. It doesn't need to do that. Maybe it can be like separable. Okay, see what I'm saying? All right. When I look at equation 4, it's just 2. Equation 5, it's just 2. It's not just 2 unknown. Right? Equation 4 has 2 unknown, VGTD and HRTD. Equation 5 has just 2 unknown. So I start with equation 4. I rewrite it. VGTB in terms of HRTB. So this means my VGTB, where's VGTB? VGTB can be expressed in the form of HRTB. And I can substitute it over there too. So I can reduce one more unknown from all the equation. So I write VGTB in terms of HRTB. Okay, substitute equation 4 to equation 1. No, now I don't have VGTB as unknown anymore. But there are some updates that I need to have. Like equation 1 become equation 1 prime. Okay, that's the math. You can check it. I wish it's correct. I think it's correct. Okay. Now equation 5, 3, and 2. I can substitute equation 5 into equation 2 and equation 3 because equation 5 is just relationship between 2, right? So now I try to write, I try to remove VLTB from the unknown. So I write VLTB as a function of something else, right? I write VLTB as a function of something else and substitute it into equation 3. This is equation 3, you need to substitute over there. And equation 2, I need to substitute VLTB over there. Right. So I have equation 3 prime and 2 prime. It's not that beautiful, but it's okay. You see the idea, right? Now I remove 2 unknown over there. I end up with 3 equation 3 unknown. Right? Now you can see what is the next step that I can do. I can manipulate equation 1 prime to be 1 double prime. Or I can manipulate equation 3 prime to be 3 double prime. Right? So I rearrange equation 3 prime to be 3 double prime. By doing so, I write VLOS in terms of HRTB. So I have VLLS equal to something, something, something. It's just rearranging, okay? And then I get equation 3 prime. Of course, I substitute equation 3 prime in equation 2. I 3 double prime into equation 2. Then I have 2 equation 2 unknown. Okay? So equation 2 double prime after the substitution look a little bit long, but it's not long, it's just long. Alright, then I have equation 1 prime. Okay, and I try to do rearrange it from equation 1 to 1 double prime. Let's go back a little bit. What do we have left? Right now we have beta and HRTB. From equation 1 prime, I can write beta equal to something, right? So I write beta equal to something in terms of HRTB. Substitute this whole thing into equation 2 prime, I mean 2 double prime. So I have to substitute it over there and over there. Then I have one equation 1 unknown, 2 triple prime as a function of HRTB. A little bit boring, I know that you can do it. Okay, I wish that you can do it, and people may want to hire you to do this. Not everyone wants to do this, because it requires someone who won't give up when see equation. Many people, especially those who is not engineer, when they see a lot of equations, they all cannot solve, we give up. That's not you. Okay, you try. So this is just substitute everything into that. What is the difference between this method and other people's method? Okay. Other people's method is this. That I have seen, when they see equation, they freak out, they stop. That other people's method. My method is, I write it out. What is the unknown? What is the equation? Can we reduce it? Which one that have just relationship between two unknown? You see what I'm saying? So this is the approach to tackle this problem in a systematic way. And eventually you have one equation and unknown. Okay, two triple pound. And two triple pound is a little bit long, but it's one equation with one unknown that can be solved by Goldstein. On the other side. But why did that? Whatever I write over here is correct. So you may try Sylvester method. Is it the same as this? What Sylvester method suggests? Bo and Chohan. Okay, but you can do this, right? Newton Raphson, I have one equation, one unknown. I think they have something similar to this. Is it? Alright, but it may not be identical. Okay. After we calculate everything, we get one equation, one unknown. We just use Goldstein to get HRTB. And then you solve it in reverse to get all the unknown. That's it. Any question? Do you want to do it? As a homework? You should have homework today, should you? Should you not?
No.
Oh, really?
So let's
take home exam should be due tonight and you should not be free of the burden. So take home exam, comprehensive model. So yeah, you should have homework 5 on 11/6. Do you want me to keep my promise? I should give you homework 5. Which is gonna be fun. It's because you just use Goldstein. If you use my method. You can use other method. Okay, but this is, I think this is a good one too. No question? So this means if you have vertical flow where the cap part is short compared to the whole bubble, you can use this. Question?
Is all the procedure is with the rational system? All the procedure variables are the phases or as is